Alright, the May State of My Galaxy. Man, this crept right up. I mean, I was just kind of relaxing, hanging out the other day and took a glance at my calendar. And, like, obviously I knew it was getting later in the month because Memorial Day and stuff, but it just didn't register with me what the date actually was. And I look and I'm like, oh my god, what? I gotta do the State of My Galaxy shortly. And here it is, today's shortly. So anyways, got quite a few things to talk about. Ironically, I do have a lot of ship stuff to talk about as well. I only say that's ironic because ships typically are pretty stagnant. I mean, not much goes on with ships. You know, there's not usually a lot of new ships. There's just not a lot going on. But this month, I do have quite a bit. But anyways, per usual, I'm just going to start with characters. But before characters, is this going to show it? No, it's not. Okay, that's kind of annoying. I wanted to show my GP. I hit 8 million GP this month, and not only did I hit it, I destroyed it. I'm almost at 8.2 million GP, which is pretty cool how quickly that blew up. It always seems like when you get close, it takes forever to reach that threshold. And then once you get there, you just shatter it. Like, I remember being at like 7.9, and I was like, man, I hope I hit 8 million before the State of My Galaxy, and like I hit 8 million like 2 weeks ago now. But anyhow, 8 million. So that's pretty cool. It's exciting. I remember nowadays an OP player is probably at 12 million, but I remember when 8 million was a lot. That's a few years ago when Arnold was at 8 million. It was like, geez, boy. Now here I am. I'm at 8 million. But it's just not as impressive anymore. Like I said, there's 12 million. Anyways. On to my characters. So I guess to start, I'll talk about this guy. Beskar Armor Mando. I don't care about him. I never have. I never really thought he was that good. Never thought he was that impressive. Regular Mando is awesome. I like regular Mando. Beskar Armor, don't really care. But I have been working on him because of his ship. Obviously, this is a bounty hunter ship, and I use it with my executor squad. So I figured I might as well beef him up so then the ship's a little more beefy. Prior to me getting him to Relic 6, which just happened yesterday. Was it yesterday or was it earlier today? Maybe it was earlier today. I'm just thinking of the game's day. In the game, I'm on a new day, but technically right now, it's still the same day for me. It's 11:30 at night, so it's still today. It's not tomorrow yet. But anyways, he was only gear 12, so I have gotten him quite a ways up. I plan on just taking him to Relic 7. That should be good enough for the ship purposes. One thing I will say, though, even though I've never been super, like, impressed with him or anything, I was using him somewhere. I think I was using him maybe in Grand Arena. And I had him under, like, a mall lead or something like that. And I don't know if the mall lead made a difference, but, you know, he did his discipline setup and then did the swift takedown move. And there was five characters, practically full health and stuff still. And when he did the swift takedown, he took them all right out. And I was like, whoa, what the heck just happened there? So I don't know if that's because of the Maul lead. I don't know if that's because of him being Relic 6. He's just so much better. Well, actually, he was only Relic 5 at that time. But, you know, I don't know if it's because of his relics. I don't know, but that was pretty awesome. I never saw that happen before. So that it could change my mind. I'll try him again in some more Grand Arenas and see what happens. Maybe he is secretly good once he's reliced. I don't know. But that was pretty cool. Anyways, so I got him up. The dog, as I call him. I got him. Did I get him up yet? Yeah, I think I got him up this month, Relic 5. And his mods are almost there as well, as you see. Working on those bottom two to 6 dot. Death Trooper. Death Trooper's paused right now at Relic 6. I do plan on getting him to Relic 7 for a couple reasons. One, obviously the ship, like I always say. But two, is because of the whole reason why I worked on him in the first place. Which is for the... what is it? I don't know what it's called, but it's that event where you go up against Ewoks. And it's you can use droids or Empire. So, Challenge Tier 3, I haven't ever been able to complete. But I saw some videos that showed, like, whoops, Empire squads that could take them out. And one of the Empire squads was something like, what's their name? Stark and the other guy that looks like him with Piat and Death Trooper and Range Trooper. And I don't even think their Death Trooper and Range Trooper are that beefy, but I'll get mine beefed up before I try again. But yeah, it was full auto and they won, so I was like, okay, I guess I gotta do that. So yeah, Death Trooper at the beginning of this month wasn't even worked on, now he's Relic 6. Maul, I don't know if I did anything. I don't know what the status of him is, if he got up any status at all this month. If anything, I got him to gear 12 this month. He could be reliced, obviously. I got Mando up and all that, but I haven't really been focused on him because I don't have a real use for him. It's not like I have Lord Vader or anything, so he's just kind of a fun, cool character to work on, but there's no real purpose for me right now. Fennec Shand. I got her up almost to relic status, super close. She wasn't worked on and now she's super close. All I need is 11 more of those and then 42 of those. So that's a lot, but then she'll be reliced. And then it's just get her up to relic 7. That way then I can meet that other requirement, I should say, for Jabba. What else have I done? Anything cool? Actually, where is he? Range Trooper. Like I said, I worked on Range Trooper. Not too much progress. He's gear 12. It's a start. I figured once I got Death Trooper to Relic 7, then I could focus on him maybe. Shore Trooper, I worked on. Not really for any reason other than the ship. You know, I had Death Trooper over here up at Relic 6, and then I was like, Shore Trooper was just, you know, gear 1, level 1 and all that. And I was like, dang it, if I'm going to work on him and boost up the ship a little, I might as well work on Shore Trooper to make it even, so eventually Shore Trooper will get to relics and stuff as well, just for the purposes of the ship. Otherwise, nothing special with him, it's all for the ship. I have Aura Sing and Chrysanthan favorited here, because, well, those are the two requirements, besides the Outrider, that I need to farm for Jabba, you know, to 7-star first off. So they're just there, just as like a reminder. Obviously, they both use Cantina energy, and obviously I'm trying to work on relics, so farming them is kind of on the back burner, because I'd rather do relics, but still, it is something to think about. Anything down here? Oh yeah, I got Ninth Sister up to Relic 6. I chose her because she's the tank, and I've seen instances, like videos maybe from Arnold or somebody, where their Inquisitor team was quite a pain in the dick to get through because Ninth Sister was just tanking it like nobody's business. Obviously, there was probably good mods and all that with that as well, but still, I figure, well, Relic 6, get her a little beefier. I feel like I'm probably going to have to get the whole squad to at least Relic 7 just to be able to do the, what's his name, Grand Inquisitor event, but I don't know. But to start, I got her to Relic 6. Oh, and I got her mods beefed up, if you didn't notice them over there. You know, she's got those green ones and three greens, three blues. Because again, I figure, you know, the more I can add to her, possibly the better. Let's see. I got all my Inquisitors up to Relic 5 this month. I'm pretty sure it was this month I got them all there. So... oh yeah, I also put the Omicron on Second Sister. I don't know if that was this month, but it is something that happened, and I don't know if I called it out when it did happen. So, just call it out now. Too high up over here. Anything else? I think this was last month, but I put Shreya and Nihilus to Relic 5. Again, I don't remember if I called it out, so I'll just call it out now. Oh yeah, all these Inquisitors right here in a row. I feel like there's somebody that I was working on before and I just completed their mods. Not like it matters, but still. No, Savage was last month. I was going to mention Savage Press being Relic 7 and Omicron, but I talked about that last month, so never mind. Anything else cool happen? I don't think so. Well, at least not here. I did put Chief Chirpa's Omicron on him. I didn't really know who else to put it on. I don't really have anybody that I'm super excited about. Everybody's kind of worthless. Either A, because I don't care about their Omicron, or B, they're just gear 12. So, it was difficult, but I felt like out of all my crap options, he was probably the best. So, He's good as Omicron. I never use Ewoks in Grand Arena. I never use Gear 12s in Grand Arena. So I'm sure I'll never see that Omicron in action, but it's there, so. Chief Nebbit. That's right. I gave him his Omicron a while. I always forget about that, too. Not to talk about it. I just forget in general. What is it even for? Is he Territory Wars? Yeah, I don't use him in Territory Wars ever. So I forget he has it. Just like I guess someone else random with their Omicron. I think it's... where is he? Finn. Yeah, I gave Finn his Omicron. Never used it because I always forget about it. Poggle. I did talk about giving him his Omicron. How about star increases? Did I get anybody starred up? Pretty sure I did. Boosh. I think Boosh made it this month, finally. Yeah, she did. I've been farming the crap out of her, and finally she made it. So that's good, because, you know, it's a job of requirement. Who else? Oh, Armor. I think Armor made it this month as well, so that was pretty cool. I've been working on her forever. I mean, I've been kind of working on her casually. Like, it hasn't been anything that I've been fully, like, dedicated to. It's just been a passive grind, but it's still good that she's done now. No more worrying about passively grinding for her. Rose is super pointless, but I got her to 6-star. Then it's a long journey that I don't care about to 7-star. Kyle Katarn. Was that this month? I also got him the 6-star. It might have been the monthly login that helped me get that to happen. Sorry about all these coughs and stuff that I'm having and these gaps in when I'm talking and I stop. It's just I'm having like raging heartburn for no reason out of nowhere right now. And it's making things very difficult. Anyway, Sortie. I got Sortie up to 5-star. This happened just the other day. I don't know if that's cool or not. I feel like it is, but I don't really care enough. Do we have any unlocks this month? Maybe just Saw Gerrera. That's kind of boring. Let's see. As far as these conquest characters, I'm sort of getting close to Boba Fett, Sianna Jango. 250 out of 330. What is that? 80. So that's 4 more conquests. 4 more conquests, and I'll be able to have him unlocked. So that's still a while. You get like what, 1 conquest a month? So you're looking at 4 months. And I'll have them unlocked. So that's a while, but I guess it's progress. Darth Malgus is the one I'm most pumped about. And it's like, it's about time he's in the Proving Grounds event. I'm nowhere near getting him. 125 out of 330. But still, at least I can finally get shards for him because Conquest wasn't doing it for me before. Trench, don't care about him. Ben Solo, kind of confused on him why he's not in the Conquest thing yet. Isn't he been around longer than Malgus? I don't know. Kind of random, but Third Sister, I got 11 shards of her. It's not like I'll be unlocking her anytime soon, but still. Better progress than I thought I'd have. So I guess that's it for characters. Now on to ships. Like I said, there's a whole bunch of stuff that happened. So one, obviously the Razor Crest has been increased significantly. I don't remember what it was before. Maybe only went up like 10,000 power, but still, 10,000 more power. The Ebon Hawk has gotten some goofy power only because of me working on the dog. So I've been thinking about maybe I should work on him. I don't care about him at all, but well, he has an Omicron, so there is that as well. But anyways, I'm like, well, I could work on him just for the ship. I don't know, we'll see. I don't really care about him or the ship enough, but I've heard that ship's a good option when the Executor is beefed up enough. So right now mine's only the basic 4-star, but when I can have more reinforcements, it might be good to work on the Ebon Hawk more, kind of like I did with Razor Crest. So I don't know, we'll see in the future. I kind of already showed this, the TIE Reaper, you know, it's gotten significantly boosted because both of those characters I didn't have worked on at the end of last month, and now I got 1 Relic 6 and 1 almost Gear 12, so huge boost to that ship. And then, is that it for current ships? Nope, another current ship thing that I've gotten done is this one. Again, this is something I've been grinding forever. Finally got it to 6-star. Obviously, it's got a whole other star to go, but still, 6-star now, so that's kind of cool. It's, you know, that much more beefy. And I think that might be it for increase type things. So now there's unlocks. I've had quite a few unlocks, and they're cool unlocks too. First one, and I actually don't know if it's first, but the first one I see is this one. This is the TIE Interceptor. This is one of the Conquest ships. So I heard it's good, and now it's cool. I finally have it. So of course I worked on it right away. I mean, I have the crew at Relic 5, so I'm like, well, what the heck? It's not like it's a weak crew. So yeah, that's cool. And I already have 10 out of 85 shards too towards getting it to 6-star. So that was exciting. The second thing that was kind of cool is this ship. This is the new ship that was just released on a Galactic Chase event. Got it unlocked. It's a piece of trash ship. I'm not super excited about it, but it's still cool. One, like just like the last one. I have Sith Trooper at Relic 5 and 2. I mean, this is a ship that just came out and I already have it. So it's kind of cool. That doesn't happen all the time for me. And I'm at 26 out of 65 for Relic 5. I mean, start. Wow. To go to 5-star. I don't know how long this event is going for. But I'm hoping that I have enough time to at least get it to 5-star. That'd be pretty cool. Because then I can also, let me go back into this. Then I can also unlock this. Right now, obviously, I'm gated because I'm not 5-star. So that would help. What else happened? I am getting close to unlocking this ship. Not like it matters right now. I don't know when or if I need to work on Iden, but we're getting there. Oh, yeah, I do have this ship. It's just close to getting the 6-stars. Never mind. I don't know why I was thinking I have to unlock it. This one's getting close. It's taking forever, but this is a requirement for Java to be 7-star. So I'm super close. 15 more shards and I'm at 7-star. So that's getting exciting. I've been casually farming the MG-11 Star Fortress and the Raven's Claw. Don't really care too much about them, but, you know, they're slowly getting there. Ironically, I didn't realize that their starting numbers were the same. 44 to 65 and 45 out of 85. Also, ironically, they're chronological. 44, 45. and then capital ships, I mean, they're pretty stagnant. Nothing's gonna happen except for A, Raddus when it gets to 7-star, and B, Executor getting to 5-stars, taking forever. And I still need 2 more events because you get 10 shards per event. So the first one will put me at 60, and then when it comes back around again, it'll be at 70, which I can finally get them beefed up. Which will be good because I was thinking this will add so much power to like my whole entire fleet squad arena thing, you know? One, the ship going to 5-star will increase the total power. 2, all of these moves I will be able to beef up. 5-stars, need 5-stars, need 5-stars, so I can get all those slightly stronger. And 3, pretty sure you'll get a reinforcement unlocked. So now I can add another ship as well, which will just help so much. So, super looking forward to that. It just takes absolutely forever. Ugh. Anyways, is there anything else? Oh, yeah, there's one more random thing. So, hopefully nothing weird happened. Yeah, okay, we're still good. So, here we go. So, I don't know what the F happened, but maybe like a week ago, I was booted out of my guild. Like I said, I have no idea why. I obviously am super active. I mean, obviously, I make videos and all that. I'm pretty active. I participate in everything. I complete everything that I can complete. So, not sure why they'd boot me. I mean, even if they had, like, a weird GL requirement. I have, 4? And I'm making progress towards a 5th one. So, it's not like, you know, they're like, why doesn't he have any GLs? Let's just get rid of them or something stupid. I don't know what happened. All I do know is there was a message in the comments section, like, you know, this, and it said something like, important note in Discord, go see it. And I didn't go check, because I thought, it's probably something stupid. It's just probably going to be about, like, territory war or something. They always make it sound more important than it's, oh, go check Discord for this, it's so important. And then you look and you're like, this was dumb. It's just talking about, oh, this is what our strategy is going to be. And I don't care. Like, I have the Discord just to shut everyone up. So then it's like, yeah, I'm on Discord. But I don't look at it. I don't care. I don't use it. So anyways. Yeah. So that's what I thought it was about. But then when I saw I was kicked out, I was like, well, what the F? Was there something on there that talked about what was happening? Is there something that you're supposed to go see and, like, acknowledge? And then they'd let you stay in the guild? Or was the guild disbanding? I don't know. There was nothing. Even after I got kicked out, I went to Discord. Like, well, what the F happened? And, you know, because I'm still, I can still see those forums and stuff. And nothing. There's nothing there that signifies what happened. I don't know what happened. I don't know why I got kicked out. So, obviously, I need to be in a guild. So, I searched and ended up finding this one called Perimeter Patrol. The story over here just says fun but active, 7.5+ million GP, which I'm good. I'm over 8 million. And then it just talks about, like, those requirements. Light side, you get 24 stars. Dark side, they're doing 32. 20 plus KM. 4 to 5 GLs preferred, which I have 4. I'm working on a 5th, so I barely meet their requirements, but still. And then they put this stupid Discord thing, which, whatever. I put it in, like I said, to make them happy, but I don't really care. Hold on a minute, where am I? I don't want to sidetrack, but I don't see... How do I have 0 raid tickets? I already did all my dailies, so, like, what is the raid ticket for today? Well, this is just going to show me. What? What are the raid ticket requirements for today? That's stupid. Anyways, so yeah, I don't know what happened, but I was kicked out of my guild. So now I got a new guild. But yeah, I think that's it now. Let me see my status also on this. I'll just, you know, because this is something I'm actively working on. Is trying to get Jabba. I'm at 10 out of 16. So, yeah. Almost 11. Once the Outrider gets to 7 stars. I mean, relatively speaking, that's an easy requirement to make. Once it's 7 stars, it's done. I don't have to do anything. It just says be 7 stars. And then Fennec, I'm working on her, so it's still going to be a little bit of a grind to get her to Relic 7, but still, working on her, so that could be 12 right there. And then it's just Aura Sing and Chrysanthan. Those ones are going to gate me. That's going to take forever for me to get them to 7 stars and then the required relics. But, yeah, we're getting there. I'm working on it. Anyways, I'm pretty sure that's it now. I hope there's nothing I'm forgetting. If there is, maybe, you know, I'll think of it later and add it in the comments or in the description, or I'll just add it to next month's video. Kind of like how I was talking about Nihilus and Treya in this one, because I didn't fully remember if I already covered them or not. So anyways, if you stuck along with me this whole entire time, thanks for checking this out with me, and until next time, I said see ya.